This is what we're painting today, but feel free to change things up as we go along. Pictured here are the paints that you'll be using to paint your picture today. Circled are two pens that are optional if you would like them for details, and that is a black Sharpie pen if you've got one of those, and one of my favorite tools is a white jelly roll pen. First colors we'll be using today are blue and white. Do not use all of the blue and all of the white together. Use some blue and some white to create the shade of sky that you would like to paint. So I painted the sky this shade of blue. It's a light blue, and I also used some just straight blue to go ahead and put at least one layer from my book there on the bottom. Next color to be used is the green, and we're going to use the green for the grass. Instead of just painting a flat green over the surface for the grass for my first layer, I'm going to do more, it looks like strokes, to create the effect of grass, and we will be layering more colors on there to create the field that the lines are in. After my initial layer of green, I've used the darker brown to come in and add some darker areas that I will build up from. Here I've added another layer of green on top. I've used the lighter brown or the raw sienna to go ahead and fill in the lions, and the dark brown to add the trunk of the tree in the background. Now I've put in another layer for the grass using the lighter brown. Here I've mixed the green with the dark brown that I'm going to use for the tree. I've painted in the tree, the first layer, and filled in some more of the grass. For the whites of the eyes on the cub, I've used a skinny brush and dipped the very tip into white paint so I can just create two circles for the eyes of the cub. And for the eyes of the big lion, I did use a tip of a smaller brush to paint in. And I can see I've also filled in the colors of the books. I've used red and the light brown for the other colors, but you can mix whatever colors you prefer. Here's the fun part where you can start adding details that makes them become more alive. So I've added in some white details using the very tip of my brush, but again, if you have the jelly roll pen, you can add in highlights that way if you're more comfortable. I've added in the whisker areas, the nose, the ears, another layer on the tree in the background, and the claws as well with the black. More details added here. I've added titles to the books, and you can create whatever titles you prefer. I've added details to the tree in the background, some birds flying, some more accents in the mane of the big lion, and highlights in the eyes of the lions. For the final touch, I outlined the lion and the cub and the tree and the books. You do not have to do this step. You can leave them as is from the last slide, or fill in whatever else you want to have your completed lion picture.